to float. It was directed by Andy Muschietti and is based off of the Stephen King novel of the same name. I happen to love Stephen King. He is one of my favorite authors, if not my most favorite author. Now, I've never actually read It, the book, in its entirety, but from what I do remember from reading it in high school was just how terrifying of a concept it was. First of all, clowns are already perceived as being pretty terrifying by most people. I've never been afraid of clowns myself, but I do admit they make me a bit uneasy. And I can certainly see why people are scared of them. And if you have a phobia of clowns, God help you, because the clown in this movie is terrifying. I should mention that I've also seen the 1990 miniseries with Tim Curry, and I liked it. I thought it was pretty good. It wasn't that scary, but it was really funny and entertaining. The 2017 remake, on the other hand, while it does have some funny moments, it's not afraid to scare the pants off of you either. This one in certain scenes amps up the horror to the max. I was genuinely scared at some parts, and most of you know how much of a horror movie fanatic I am, so when I say that, you know I actually mean it. And going into this movie, I actually wanted it to scare me, but as they say, be careful what you wish for. Okay, let's talk about the cast. I loved the kids of It. I genuinely cared for each of them. When all this terrifying stuff is going on and they're in peril, I was actually really scared for them at some points. It's pretty uncommon these days when you actually feel empathy and sympathy for the main characters of a horror film. The slasher genre has made a whole trope of manipulating the audience into cheering for the killer because they make the main characters so annoying. The kids of It are not like that. I loved every single one of them. They were so funny and so real and so relatable. It made me remember what it was like to be a kid, which really wasn't that long ago. When I watched this movie, there was never a moment where I just kind of thought to myself, oh, can't this clown just fucking kill these kids already? I really wanted them to live. I wanted them to make it in the end. So the child actors were amazing. That's obvious. But let's get to the real star of this movie, who was Bill Skarsgård as Pennywise, the dancing clown. Oh my god, he was awesome. Everyone on the internet is already buzzing about how great he was in the movie, but I do have to make a point. For me, the impressive thing about Skarsgård's performance was that he wasn't trying to copy Tim Curry in any way, and when you see him, you see a character that he made entirely his own. He's not just copying what Tim Curry did before him. He's made this character unique to himself, which I thought was really impressive. About Pennywise in this movie is that he's unpredictable. You don't know what he's gonna do next. He can make you laugh one minute, he can scare the shit out of you the next. I can only imagine what hell these poor child actors went through when working with him, because he must have been terrifying. I mentioned before that this movie is quite funny. I actually wasn't expecting to laugh as much as I did. As I said in my American Werewolf in London review, comedy and horror are the two genres that are the hardest to blend together, but this movie did it pretty well. It wasn't so funny that I couldn't take it seriously, but it wasn't so scary that it made me forget all the jokes. It was surprisingly all well balanced, which is really hard to do. But now that I think about it, there were a lot of moments in the film where I wasn't really sure how to react. I didn't know if I was supposed to laugh or be scared. If you've seen the movie, you know probably which scenes in particular I'm referring to. Another thing that really surprised me about this film was just how much heart it had. It's so easy for horror films to fall into the trap of being bland, soulless stories that only aim to scare and do nothing else. And we've seen many of these kinds of films coming out over the past decade or so. That way of filmmaking to me is just so wrong. A movie can be scary, but if the story sucked, I'm not gonna remember it after 10 minutes. It has a good story. It takes necessary pauses to delve into the life of these kids and what they're going through and the emotions and trauma that they're dealing with. The film really tries to make you believe that these kids are living in a world that really doesn't care about them and doesn't care if they go missing. There was even one scene towards the end of the film where I had tears in my eyes. It just moved me so much. And it takes a really special horror film to emotionally compromise me like that. So well done, movie. That was the moment for me when I realized that this was not just an average spooky film. This film has heart, and it cares about its characters a lot. It's a lot of fun, and it's really scary, but the story is fantastic as well, and that is the most important part. It far exceeded my expectations, and yes, it was definitely better than the miniseries in almost every way. Tim Curry was great, and he'll always have that going for him, but for me, the remake is superior. This is one of the very, very few instances where a remake is better than the original. How often can you say that? I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope you have a happy Halloween. This is the Cinema Cynic, signing off.